something about that intro I love. That's kind of the weirdest thing I find about this game is, by today's standards, it probably looks like garbage, but you just feel like an epic hero when you play through it.
Yeah, like, given what was capable, or given what the SNES was typically considered capable of, like, back in the day, this actually does look pretty impressive.
In fact, they had to, like, integrate a new chip into the cartridge.
Yeah, they, for the FX chip, right? Is this plugged in?
Yeah. You got, like, a little thing in the window so you can see what all the controls do.
Oh, I see. Nice.
Took me a little while to figure out what in the world that window was for as well.
Yep, you still better all. Okay, cool. Let's start this up.
Okay, now, unlike Star Fox 64, you get one of three paths. I would suggest going through path one, which is known as level one. I just moved the arrow. There we go.
Okay, this is level one?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
So, for the record, I've never played this game before. I've seen it played, but never done it myself.
I'll try to assist as well as I can, but there's... The only way to really do it is...
Star Fox team, our last resort is to counterattack Venom. Good luck!
I just find it so weird how much clearer it is on the Super Nintendo version.
It is!
Than the 64
it
version.
Sounds much better on this version.
Because on the 64 version, it's just like. And plus, I think it's because they had, like, an echo effect in the line.
Maybe.
Just taking this music.
Oh, yeah. I don't know why they changed it for the 64 version. Cornelius' theme is awesome.
Well, I think they wanted it to be a little more dramatic. Because, I mean, here it's a little more...
Oops! I think I just bombed Peppy.
I think so, too! It looked like you blew up the team there, but I guess not. Yeah, so you can fly through the rings and, you get all this stuff.
I know that, you moron!
What is that from?
That's Star Fox Adventures.
Okay. Well, that makes sense. Yeah, I think it's a gold ring with more health. Yeah, there's no silver rings in this game, it's just gold. Which could be good or bad. Those are missiles.
Oh, that was an enemy. I thought it was a power rush.
Out of my way. Hey, don't get me.
Oh, I shot him.
Yeah, there's a bomb.
I admit, I can't really make out a lot of this.
It's alright. I'm trying, well, not to, like, hold back my rage, but I mean, like, I'm just kind of like, I'm more familiar with this, I'm just like, oh, you want to go this way?
Right, I know that feeling so well.
Robot carrying another piece of the architecture. Excellent, we're going to give you a lot of health.
I thought you said the what set of lines. You lied to me.
Forgot about those ones.
Okay, so I see. So there's no silver rings except for the ones that are. Got it.
Pretty much.
Broke, help me! Wow, so 64 really was a remake of this game, wasn't it?
I think so.
Like, because I'm seeing a lot of the same stuff. And then they remade this on Star Fox 3DS. And then they remade it again to Star Fox Zero. I just don't think Nintendo knows how to continue the series. Because they made Adventure and Assault, and both of those were sort of only okay. And they keep re-releasing this.
For most people, the pinnacle is like, 64.
Yeah.
And after that, it was just garbage.
Can
you have to pause it? There we go.
Seem to be experiencing some technical difficulties.
It only happens on this set for some reason. Yeah, give it a second.
You fool.
Nope, come on. Let me just try it this way. There.
Hey!
You might recognize this voice.
Oh, I certainly do.
It's kind of interesting, but I didn't know about the secret boss of Star Fox 64 until after I played this game.
So really?
When I saw it, I'm just like, wait, I've seen this guy before.
See, I was first introduced to Star Fox 64 through my cousin, who knew the game like the back of his hand at the time he showed me. So he only went to the secret path. So for the longest time, I didn't know there was just a normal boss. And the first time I played, I missed a ring. He's like, oh wait, I forgot about this. Because he was so used to doing the secret path.
Yeah. There you go.
Who are you guys? We're Star Fox!
You'll never defeat Andross!
Well, that's pretty cool. So far, so good. I find it amusing how deep Falco's voice is.
Yeah, because I'm used to him kind of sounding like, I'm not really sure how to describe his voice in the 64 version.
Well, it doesn't sound like this 64.
Yeah. Like, here he sounds like a macho man, and the other one is just kind of like a...
Macho man?
Oh yeah,
I'm the cream of the crop. Slap into a Slim Jim.
Okay, let me see if I can do this like Pepper's voice. Andross's forces intend to build a base in this area. Destroy the rock crusher Star Fox.
Goodbye.
Ooh! Did I do that, or is this just part of the... I think I prefer first person, actually.
It makes it a little easier in this one. Because unlike 64, enemies don't really come from behind. I mean, that's the thing. It's nice that they give you the first person perspective, but... You miss
yeah,
the enemies that
I really do, I don't use it very much in the 64 version.
I mean, if there was like a rearview mirror, like, say, how they had it in Twisted Metal as first person, but it really works.
Get lost, you bean.
There he is.
Is that Peppy or the guy that's also Star? It's the guy that's also Star.
Right guy. I think I got him.
Ah, what? Not a happy.
You may notice that your right arrow is orange, or maybe a slightly darker gray on this screen. That's because the wing got ripped off.
Oh, I did not realize that.
Clear out, Astro Geeks.
Astro Geeks?
Yeah. Hey, don't get so greedy.
Is he talking to me?
Yeah,
I crashed.
Well, at least you get your wing back.
Oh, they didn't even yell no.
No!
Incoming enemy craft.
Yeah, this game probably has a lot more speech than most of the other ones, but not very not words that we can understand. It's kind of like say. Does an Animal Crossing do that sort of thing?
It does.
Basically, they just kind of go,
Everyone speaks Animalese, that's the game calls it.
So then
and it sounds different for every character who speaks it, but somehow it's a common language. Maybe. Thanks for the save.
Thanks for the save. I do kind of like it when they write dialogue like that they give them an accent, so to speak.
Yeah, it gives them more personality, I think, than just saying, thank you.
Yeah, it's like, it's really sad.
I have to say, I definitely like Slippy better in this version.
Slippy is obviously a man in this version.
I mean, he is in every version, except you wouldn't be able to tell that.
It's because he's, like, supposed to be a 12-year-old in 64.
Is he?
I don't know how young he is.
I mean, I think he's the youngest of the team at that point, granted, but I don't think he's supposed to be 12.
I guess he's just has a really high voice. And hey, if Sylvia was 11, I think that would kind of add an interesting dynamic to the team.
Yeah, because the Star Fox team wouldn't actually have a woman until Crystal joined, and she's actually genuinely kind of annoying. Well, in Assault she is. I never played Adventure.
Oh, that's a checkpoint.
Awesome. Did that get me outfield?
Yep.
Nice. Okay, well, he's still inexperienced, I say.
And they all, they can only get trapped by enemies, but I'm like, 64.
But that's twice in this one level. I'm still gonna get the same.
It's kind of random, just. Like, occasionally Falco will have somebody on his tail, and he's just like, somebody's bogey on all six. Mm-hmm. Well, this guy could be trouble. Yeah. And then when you shoot him, he's just like,
I barely heard anything from Falco this entire game.
It's kind of randomized. Sometimes you'll hear more from other characters and other ones. Try to aim for the middle of the triangle, that's how you can kill it. Gotta do that 3 times, watch out.
Boss time. Oh, jeez!
You can take out all four of those with a single bomb every time you just roll. Oh, there you go.
Nice!
Then do the same thing again down there. Then shoot the middle after the... Okay, the middle piece is going to come towards you. Shoot the middle.
Ah, no, don't die again.
You can do this.
My dodging skills are not the best.
It's alright.
Stage -2? Oh no, I didn't realize it was that bad at the game.
All of a sudden, I think you're doing a lot better than I did my first time.
Well, again, it's probably because this resembles 64 so much.
Yeah.
Like, the Rock Crusher actually did look a lot like it did in 64.
Yeah, I guess kind of. That was the one driven by the ape that said, I cannot allow you to go with you.
Yes. I am no match for you. I am in defeat.
You're not as stupid as you. He's probably my favorite character in the game.
Yeah, that's the great thing about 64, is even the bosses have a lot of personality. And they're not just generic bad guys.
That's what I find pretty interesting about going through Sector 7 is,
66, you mean?
Is it 6? Yes.
I believe it is 6.
Yeah, because they just kind of be like, at the very beginning, it's just like, come in here, no problems, some guy gets shot, you copy? Emergency maneuvers!
I thought you just said no problem, Cameron, what the hell?
That's probably what his boss is saying. And then along the way, it's just like, just broken through the first line. They've broken through the second line?
Yeah, I love how he just freaks out.
And then the boss of it is just like, these guys are crazy.
Uh-huh. Ow. Okay, I may have screwed this up. Nope! I'm afraid your faith in me was very much misplaced.
That's the game. Well, if you want, I can
show
you what Path 3 looks like.
Please do!